This is ContactTalkRadio.com, Consciousness in Action, and you are taking action into your consciousness by tuning into Contact Talk Radio.
And on TuneIn.com, Hing.fm, and UpSnap Mobile.
Contact Talk Radio.
Conscious Shift with Julianne Turner brings insights from leading voices and visionaries across the globe to guide and inspire you to create your own conscious shift into your true power and singular greatness. Through her expertise, author, speaker, and social innovator, Julianne Turner, a world authority on the creative process, guides you to discover how to consciously create the life, work, and world you most desire. And now here's your Conscious Shift host, Julianne Turner.
Welcome, everyone. This is Julianne Turner. This is Conscious Shift, and we are so glad that all of you Conscious Shifters are joining us from across the globe for today's show. You're going to really enjoy it and learn a lot and be inspired. You know, I am always so glad and joyful to hear from you across the globe and hear how you are shifting consciously your life and your work, your prosperity, and the world through sharing your gifts and genius. And I have in this time, this season of gratitude and gifts, a gift for you. If you go to www.consciousshiftshow.com, right there you can get a gift from me, a Conscious Shift Genius Guide with Seth Godin, one of the leading visionaries on our planet, as most of you know. This is an audio and action guide that is going to inspire you to share your own genius. It's going to give you some nuggets of gold to, and some clear action steps, okay, to shift your prosperity and inspire you to your highest potential. So go to ConsciousShiftShow.com and pick up that gift. And speaking of gifts, as you all know, on Conscious Shift, we are always talking about how we can use our creative power to consciously choose to create the world we truly wish to see, and how we each contribute our unique gifts and genius to generate all that we need to bring that new desired world into being. And yet, if that's true, why are we still shocked seeing war and refugees and shootings and things that are totally out of alignment with the world that we here in our Conscious Shift community wish to see? Well, the answer is really simple. It's just that not everyone is consciously choosing the same values, the same vision for our world. And a key to that is something that our Conscious Shift guest today, Karin Miller, the author of an amazing book called Global Values, A New Paradigm for a New World. Karin actually believes that finding those values that we can share and rally around across the globe is actually the key to our consciously co-creating together. That's what we're going to explore today with Karin. Karin, welcome to Conscious Shift.
Thank you so much, Julianne. It's a pleasure to be here.
It's so wonderful to have you here, Karin. And I am just so impressed by your background. Not only are you a, you know, high-level entertainment world, entertainment tech lawyer, but you are doing great things across our shared global community as well. You've been pro bono counsel to Marianne Williamson for the formation of the Global Peace Alliance, which is such a powerful alliance. And you're also an advisory board member to the Alliance for a New Humanity. Many of our listeners know that's chaired by Deepak Chopra. And you've also founded your own organization, Our New Evolution, One, O-N-E, our new evolution.org, to help get these values out in the world and help us all rally. So we're going to talk about what the values are, but what I'm most interested in just starting off is first to honor you for this work that you're doing in the world and allowing us this opportunity to explore globally shared values. And second, to say what on earth inspired you to write this guidebook to bring us together around these shared global values.
Yes, well, thank you so much. I really appreciate the acknowledgement of the work that I've been doing. I did work with Marianne Williamson, like you mentioned, and in the past was on the advisory board for the Alliance for a New Humanity. And, you know, a number of factors contributed to global values. One of them was, you know, being engaged in these many different social transformation groups, be them peace groups and spirituality and social justice and even the green movement, environmental sustainability, I started to look at them and think, what's the common thread that unites all of these different movements? What does peace have to do with sustainability and climate change? And what does social justice have to do with spirituality? And I came to the conclusion that it really is comes down to values for me. It comes down to unity consciousness and seeing everything as connected and as one body of life, that everything we do impacts everything else. And I thought, as in politics, for instance, when, the terms family values has been used and different values frameworks articulated, and I thought, well, I have values. I know this movement has values. How can I use values to explain unity consciousness and conscious evolution? And so that's where global values came from. And additionally, I've had challenges with anxiety myself and, living from a fearful perspective. And I found that adopting this paradigm, this new framework of a way to view the world helps me very much personally to shift from a fear-based mentality to a love-based mentality, helping myself connect with others and see the similarities rather than the differences.
Wow. You have shared so many nuggets there, Karin. Thank you. Thank you for that. Let's explore some of those. And yes, we're going to also explore the values that you've identified here. They're each so powerful. And I know that we could probably talk for several shows about this, but we'll try and do each one justice in terms of just shining some light on it. Okay.
Great.
Okay. So, I really hear you that as you were seeing from a more truly global view, social justice and environment and sustainability and spirituality, I'm also interested in finding out how you started to move in all those worlds together. and yet having that global view and kind of seeing the common threads, you actually stepped back and said, What brings us together? What binds us together? What threads actually do connect us? And that is a very different paradigm for our world, isn't it? It's one that's hopefully, and we talk about it here on Conscious Shift quite a bit, a new paradigm that's hopefully rising in the world. And that is the idea that you mentioned of unity consciousness, that idea that we're all one, even though our five senses, human senses, and our current worldview really kind of focuses on our differences, right? Our separateness. Isn't that true?
Yeah, the first of the global values is unity, and that together we make up one body of life. But then I added to that, our diversity is a celebration of all that is. Together we are whole. So the concept is, yes, we have many, many differences, but if we want to bridge the gaps between us and among us to make it it's helpful for us to see ourselves as one body of life. We may be just like in a human body, or each cell in a human body has a different role. But when you zoom out and to a larger perspective, you see that all of those cells work together to make one body. And I think that that perspective, I think it's both true that we are very different and we have different roles, but at the same time, if we take a perspective of unity and seeing ourselves as one community, it's helpful to bridge those gaps.
Absolutely. You mentioned the first, actually the first two values. Unity is the first value, so that we're moving not in separation and isolation, but in oneness and in allowing us to live in balance with others and our planet. And then the second value is community, that we are more powerful when we join forces toward the same value or vision. And so that's my question, Karin, here is, why values? Why would you choose values as something that unites us? Because oftentimes we see values as something that's really very personal, or even kind of given to us by our religious or traditions, in life. Why and how can values actually unite us?
Well, I've decided that I needed to take a step back from our actions. I think lots of times we look at the actions that we take and how those are affecting other people and other communities and other nations and the whole world. But really, where do our actions come from? They come from our beliefs and our values. And if we take a look at what our fundamental core values are, we can better understand where these actions come from. So I just thought that rather than focusing on the values that we may have received from our religious traditions or from our families or our cultures, a way to bridge the gap between different cultures and between different religions is to look at a new perspective of this unity consciousness. And I used values to tell that story. There's a lot of other great values that I didn't articulate as global values, but I thought it was important to capture these 10 global values to articulate some fundamental principles of this social transformation movement to unity and wholeness.
Well, I've got to hand it to you, Karin. It's such a powerful tool and huge task to try and distill this down to 10. I could only imagine, how you came to these. I'm going to read all of them, and then we'll so that our listeners can get a little bit more of a spectrum of what we're going to be talking about, and then we can take each one a little bit more in detail. Okay, so the first one and two we mentioned. Unity, which makes sense, is the first one. Community is number two. Life is number three. Freedom, four. Five is connection. Six is sustainability. Seven, creativity. Love that one. Eight is empowerment. Nine is choice. And 10 is integrity. Okay, so we've talked a little bit about why unity and why community is the first two. How did you shift for the rest of these, Karin? How did you begin to sort out and choose among the many values? You said that there was a sense of finding the core principles or universal principles that we can share. Is that right?
Yes. I came up with these 10 values over 10 years ago. So and when I did come up with them, they just kind of came to me and I wrote them down as these 10. I was thinking about, how do I capture the green movement? Well, sustainability. How do I capture the arts, creativity? How do I capture social justice and democracy, freedom? So I tried to you know, some people have done major studies on values and done polls on values, and I kind of took a very different approach of just what popped into my mind, and I wrote them down. And then from there, I explored those 10 values for around about 10 years. And through my personal growth, that's where the book came from, telling the story through these values.
Mm. That's really profound, isn't it? That they came to you and you really thought of that holistic framework, as you've talked about. What are the key areas? Arts, environment, social justice. What values are behind, that underlie all of each of those areas? And then how wonderful for you to kind of spend 10 years, Karin, kind of confirming these, seeing, you know, as you encounter stories and experiences and all your different spheres of influence, that these were confirmed and validated for you.
Yes, and I utilize these values for my own personal transformation. So, you know, shifting from a fear-based mentality, you know, feeling separate from others, feeling alone in this journey, to a state of feeling connected and a state of, you know, we talk about the shift from fear to love, from fear and separation and isolationism and competition at the expense of the whole, to moving to a state of love and connection and collaboration and a holistic approach. So I really use these values for my own personal journey from fear to love.
Mm. And we can see maybe more clearly today than ever before, and maybe even more shockingly today, Karin, that this global, this sphere, this planet that we're a part of is so interconnected, right? And while we may think that something that's happening across the globe with refugees in Syria, for instance, will not affect us, and then we find that, you know, it's generating rebellion and terrorism that is touching, you know, everyone across the globe and in Paris and, you know, all across and potentially the U.S. and all across the globe. So there's a kind of one of my favorite kind of tribal sayings, really profound but simple, is, you should take no comfort that there's a hole in my end of the boat.
Yes. We're all in the same boat.
Exactly. So we're really seeing that. And I think that we're hopefully becoming consciously aware of that. The idea that we kind of floated out at the very beginning of the show is, so how do we consciously choose, these values and that vision of the world we wish to see? And your perspective, if I'm understanding it, is that the values give us, really, the way you framed it, like 10 different angles, you know, facets, perspectives, through which we can connect with others. We can find common and shared ground. Is that right?
That's so right. And, you know, you mentioned choice, and choice is being one of the 10 global values is so important, you know, because we, as I say in the book, we have the freedom to choose what we create and destroy, how we act and react, what we value, and how we live. So that our choice is really setting up our framework for how we're going to conduct ourselves in our lives and the actions that we'll take based on those beliefs and values. And from those actions, our agreements that we'll make with others in the world, and those agreements create our social structures, they create our governments, and they create how the whole world operates. So I really think that personal individual values, when shared among many people, can have the power to transform our societies, not only ourselves individually, but our societies and the whole world.
Mm. Yeah, choices is almost like the fulcrum, right? Of how we take these beliefs, these values, and transform them into action, as you said. So unity and community, recognizing that. The third global value that you share in your book, Global Values, is life. That's a great value, I would think. What do you mean in your sense of life as a value?
You know, I talk about life as the fundamental energy and force that energizes and moves all things, and that that life force is really the core of our existence. In some points in the book, I talk about life as, you know, interchangeably with, you know, God or spirit or, you know, but I was attempting to take an agnostic approach and use life just as the energy that moves through all of us, and really as the, if you think of life as the energy and even intelligent energy, that is what connects us all. And at the same time, you know, when we're thinking about these values, we can think about life as living itself through us. If we, you know, there's the term let go and let God, but just letting life express itself through us and our own creativity. I really believe that that's the purpose of us being here. And, you know, that kind of connects to where my organization, Our New Evolution, comes from, or that are one, is that life is moving through us, connects us all, and life is evolving. And at this point, we have the opportunity to consciously participate in the evolution of life and consciousness throughout the world.
Absolutely. You're singing our Conscious Shift song here. You're in kindred spirit land here in terms of, yes, we are, as Barbara Marx Hubbard would say, you know, conscious evolutionaries and conscious creators and conscious, hopefully conscious participants. What we talk about too is that what's happening in the world, as we kind of touched on at the beginning again, is that we are already co-creating the world that we experience now. The only question is, are we consciously creating it or are we unconsciously creating it? And there are a lot of people who are not using their empowerment. They're not using their creativity for good. They're not acknowledging the value of life of all things in terms of respecting and seeing value in everyone. And they're not choosing consciously then, right? That pivot point to action. They're not choosing to express that in their actions. So that's why we see such a disparity in what many of us, and I would still say most of us, want to create. And what we're actually seeing in these hotspots around the globe, right?
Yes. You know, I think that while it does come down to choice, I think it's many people have not had the experience of being of that connection with others and with life, the life force that's evolving through us, and they just feel very isolated. They feel disconnected. They feel, you know, very discontent with their life situation. And in those situations, it's very easy to forget that we're all one body of life and that we're all connected. I use the analogy to the Wizard of Oz in the book and talk about, you know, Dorothy on her journey. But you know, she kind of gets knocked out in the whirlwind of a tornado, and she goes through a forgetting process and has to remember. You know, there's no place like home to return back home. But in the same sense, we have to remember or re-member, bring back together the many parts of our fragmented self, our fragmented human body and our fragmented human family to remember that our connection to the wall of creation and the whole body of life.
Mm. Beautifully said, Karin. And we're going to touch on a few more of these global values. We're going to take a very short break, and we will be right back. This is Julianne Turner. You're listening to Conscious Shift.
Love the voices and visionaries shared here on Conscious Shift with Julianne Turner. From spiritual guides like Marianne Williamson, Barbara Marx Hubbard, and Don Miguel Ruiz, to creative sparks like Julia Cameron of The Artist Way, and inspiring business gurus like Seth Godin and Daniel Pink, then you'll love being able to grasp their wise guidance and apply their step-by-step wisdom to the new Conscious Shift Notes Action Guide series. A version of Cliff Notes for each Conscious Shift show. With Conscious Shift Notes, they not only give you the engaging full audio interviews from each Conscious Shift visionary and the full written transcript, but now they've also taken each Conscious Shift show interview and distilled it down to its essential essence. So you get each Conscious Shift show summarized on just a few colorful visual pages with bullet points, highlights, and key quotes, so you can grasp the key points at one glance. Want to know the best news? Conscious Shift host Julianne Turner wants you to experience the inspiration of their new Conscious Shift Notes absolutely free for a limited time. With her free gift of their first Conscious Shift Notes action guide and audio series with Seth Godin, go to ConsciousShiftShow.com to receive your free gift now. In your free gift, Conscious Shift Notes said, multiple New York Times bestselling author and creative visionary Seth Godin shares in detail exactly how you can discover and profit from your own unique genius and start doing what really matters to you and to the world. Your first step is to go to ConsciousShiftShow.com right now to receive your free Conscious Shift Notes, action guide, and audio, along with their Conscious Shift Show updates from their growing global community of fellow visionaries. Most important, you'll also get to see how you can access all their Conscious Shift Show wisdom in their brand new Conscious Shift Notes collections around transformational topics they've shared, like prosperity, life purpose, creativity at work, transformational leadership, and many more. In fact, their first Conscious Shift Show Notes collection on prosperity is available now and includes Marianne Williamson on the law of divine compensation, Julia Cameron on a prosperous heart, Dan Pink on To Sell as Human, and Adam Grant on Give and Take, How True Leadership Starts with a Giving Mindset, and much more. Go to ConsciousShiftShow.com right now to claim your Conscious Shift Notes, action guide, and audios to guide you step by step to make your own conscious shift into your true greatness today.
Welcome back, everyone. This is Julianne Turner. You are listening to Conscious Shift, and we are talking today with Karin Miller, an entertainment technology lawyer, but also the author of a new book called Global Values, A New Paradigm for a New World. She is also the founder of Our New Evolution, O-N-E, ournewevolution.org is the website. And Karin believes that we can actually begin to transform ourselves and consciously transform the world by adopting and activating these 10 global values that we've been talking about that people of any race, religion, or culture anywhere in the world can align with and use to co-create, to nurture, and grow global connection. Karin, we've had the opportunity to talk about several of these beautiful global values: unity, community, life, freedom. Just before the break, we were talking about connection. We've talked about creativity and choice as ways to not only embrace our unity, but also our diverse gifts. So as we begin to shift to some of the final values here that we want to mention, sustainability and integrity. When you say sustainability, that can mean a lot of things. What do you mean by it?
So oftentimes when we think of sustainability, we think about environmental sustainability and the green movement, but that's just part of the picture in a broader view. What I'm talking about is more of a holistic perspective of sustainable actions. So we're moving from short-term individual gain at expense of the whole to long-term sustainable actions for all. So that would be, you know, not only in pertaining to the environment and climate change and all of the challenges that we face in that arena, but also our individual actions and corporate actions, you know, thinking about the long-term consequences of our actions and, you know, making sure that we support the well-being of others rather than at the expense of others.
Mm. And so I hear you about sustainability. We do often use that term, maybe most often related to the environment, but I find even more so recently it comes up with regard to our economic systems. Have you found that too?
Can you elaborate a little more on what you mean by that?
Well, in terms of having sustainable economic systems where everyone has an opportunity if our economic systems are really kind of creating a very small percentage elite, for instance.
There are some
new views on even our economic systems taking a different view at that.
Yeah, so I think you're exactly right that it's not just our ecological systems, but our economic systems. You know, currently we have most of the wealth in the top 1% of the population, and taking a new perspective and shifting to the benefit of all people and having access to resources by people all over the world.
Exactly. And that's a really fine balance, isn't it? The roots of that, of the economic system, really go deeply into our values. There's no way to pull the thread of the economy or the environment without going into our values, right?
That's exactly right. And that's the point of global values is that, we can look at our, when we think about, well, what can I do about that? How can I change economic systems? That's too much for one person or even one group, social action group. It really comes down to those systems are a reflection of the consciousness of the majority of the people around the world. Or, you know, even if we haven't created those systems, we've allowed them to manifest. So it's really claiming our authority and our power to manifest our values in society. And through those actions together, we have the power to change our economic systems, to change our environmental systems and ecological systems. There's great power in joining forces in that way.
Mm-hmm. Absolutely. And if we can see and share these values, it gives us those lines of trajectory to align along, if you will, to become that force, to use that positive force, that co-creative force. Now I know that you have some ideas, maybe just some starting points for individuals. You know, there may be so many, I'm sure. I know our conscious shifters, and they're all saying, but how can I make a difference? If there was some, you know, Karin, if there was some small step that they could take right here today to get started, how could they get started?
Well, I think that the main thing that we can do, of course, there are simple actions that we can do, like recycling and, you know, things like that. But the primary message that I'm delivering is that it really comes down to going within, taking a look at ourselves, because really all that we can really change is ourselves, and how we are interacting with others and how we are communicating in order to affect those changes on a broader level. So, you know, as kind of a play on words, in the last chapter of the book, the call to action is to meditate. It's to go within and practice mindfulness and reflection and contemplation, and align our actions with these values of unity consciousness, so that we can make sure that we are manifesting that in the world.
Okay. So each one of us can take actions as sparked by our values, and we can also go within and align our beliefs and our values with these shared principles, and thereby begin to change our actions and yeah. move them in the same direction, if you will. Now, Karin, you're not only creating a framework for us to tap into these shared values, but you also, through our new evolution, your one, our new evolution.org, would you call it an organization or is it a movement?
The intent is to use this as a movement. You know, I named it Our New Evolution so that when any one person is saying it, they have to include themselves. It's ours. It's always new. It's always something that's emergent, and we're always evolving. So the concept is Our New Evolution promotes the great initiatives of other organizations as well as those of my own that reflect global values. I think that, you know, providing a platform where we can connect all of these great initiatives and the people who are involved of all of these great initiatives for social transformation is a powerful thing. I keep going back to there's power in joining forces, and the idea behind Our New Evolution is to use global values to bring together these great projects.
Mm. And that is so important, Karin, because you have seen in your work with Marianne Williamson and launching the Peace Alliance and with Deepak Chopra in the Alliance for New Humanity. I know many of our friends here at Conscious Shift, like Humanities team with Neil Donald Walsh and Steve Farrell. There are global organizations that already have, their sacred forces across the globe. You know, consciously holding space for this, consciously already sharing, I think, these values that you have codified for us here and brought together for us. You've given us a song sheet so that we can all sing from the same one.
Oh, and that's beautiful. Thank you.
Right? And we do need a place, a platform, some kind of way to bring all of this, all of these kindred spirits, these organizations, and these global organizations, and even those focused on specific areas like education, for instance, or the environment, to be able to bring them together to unify their efforts and to be aware where we can align. So what is your vision? I know it's just emerging and will continue to evolve, but what is your vision for our new evolution?
Yes, you know, as you mentioned, there's so many great projects and organizations out there already, and I'm not attempting to say that I have the power to do anything greater than they're already doing. But at the same time, I think there's some great benefit in having some common language in order to articulate what the principles are behind this movement. And I think that, using global values to be that connecting force is a really powerful tool. I'm not saying that it's the only tool, but it's a very powerful tool to articulate what we are, what unites us, what's the common thread. You know, So I've started a campaign on global values on Facebook, and the interesting thing is that there's 277,000, over 250,000 fans on Facebook in a very short while, and most of them are young people in the Middle East and South Asia. So there's 100,000 young people ages 13 to 24 in Bangladesh. There's 60,000 people in Iraq who share global values. The next countries are Pakistan, Egypt, Afghanistan. So I think that this is a great tool, a great message to bring together different cultures and different religions together in for positive social change. The vision of our new evolution, then, is to just build on that, to continue to provide tools that help people connect who share these values all around the world. People who are not involved in, the spirituality groups or the New Age groups here, who are often articulating these messages, but people who may have never heard these messages before, or in this type of language. So I think there's great power in that, of connecting people who are looking for positive change, moving from a state of fear and, for instance, terrorism, to a state of connectedness with the rest of the world and love. Being a technology lawyer, I'm very interested in offering new technologies, new tools to help these organizations reach more people, connect more people online. Not necessarily through my website or a portal of portals, but in a distributed way, so it allows people to connect to the initiatives and projects that matter to them that reflect global values.
Wow. Karin, I'm just really feeling the significance of this with you, and acknowledging that you're already attracting through your sharing of these global values, some of our perhaps conscious shifters, potential conscious shifters in the Middle East, Southeast Asia, Pakistan, Iraq, Egypt, for you to be attracting really value holders from those countries who know that they would adopt and activate these values and share them is very powerful. Now, we want to make sure all of our conscious shifters know how to find you, how to find your Facebook group that's and the campaign that's doing so well, how to find the book. So let's take those one at a time. We mentioned your site, ournewevolution.org. It's ournew. EVOLUTION, ournewevolution.org. And Karin, help me out with the Facebook. What's the easiest way, maybe even a search term for them to search in Facebook?
Sure. On Facebook, you can just search for global values. You can also, the exact address is www.facebook.com/globalvaluesmovement, and you'll find it that way.
Okay, great. Global Values Movement, or hashtag Global Values. And then for the book, Global Values, A New Paradigm for a New World, so everyone can get this book and go deeper into all 10 of these values. Karin, where can they find that?
You can find it on Amazon.com. Just search for Global Values and my name, Karin Miller. Or you can go to my website, ournewevolution.org, and I have a link to that Amazon site there as well.
Okay, so that ournewevolution.org is perhaps the best central site,
yeah.
Conscious Shifters, to, and you can see a brief description of all 10 values there. You can find out more about Karin, and that is K-A-R-I-N, Miller, M-I-L-L-E-R. And again, the book is called Global Values, A New Paradigm for a new world. Karin, what would you like for our listeners to take away? I know we've just touched on so many things here, but what is in your heart to happen as a result of our sharing these values?
Wow, that's a big question. I really, it comes down to perhaps the last value in global values of integrity. My hope and desire is that the listeners here and people around the world come to recognize and realize and fully understand within themselves that everything is integrated, everything's one, and that everything that we do impacts everything else. And that we are together inherently complete, undivided parts of the whole. So when we remember our oneness, we act with integrity to the benefit of all. And I think, you know, deep down, it's a remembering. We have forgotten who we really are, and we remember that we are one body of life, we're one human family, and that together, with that realization, we can transform the world.
Beautiful summary, Karin. Thank you so much for being with us today. Thank you so much for your vision and for sharing and bringing together these values that we can share and do share. And thank you for all your work in the world. We'll definitely be watching the progress of our new evolution.
Wonderful. Thank you so much.
It's been a joy to have you, and we will be right back. This is Julianne Turner. You're listening to Conscious Shift.
Throughout time, all visionaries, sages, and thought leaders have used a pattern of thought, an archetype of creation, to think dramatically differently from everyone else. In fact, these visionaries begin with an entirely different worldview that enables them to see beyond what is to what can be. The good news is that we can adopt the same worldview, literally a different thinking system that all world changers throughout time have used, a profound and practical and profoundly different sequence of thought for the 21st century. This universal thinking system was discovered and is now revealed in a revolutionary book called Genesis of Genius.
Genesis of Genius, written by Conscious Shift host Julianne Turner, is a full-color step-by-step visual guidebook to guide you to use this success system to discover and profit from sharing your own unique genius. Genesis of Genius, Julianne Turner's life work and the foundation of her unparalleled success, guiding thought leaders and emerging visionaries across the globe to make both significant income and world-changing impact, is already a bestseller on Amazon and is now available to you at genesisofgenius.com. And for a limited time, you will receive $180 in special bonuses, plus an exclusive quick start guide, all available to you today when you buy your copy and register at genesisofgenius.com.
This is your moment. Let this be your turning point, and let Genesis of Genius be your guide on your quest. Now is the time to come awake and get out of the loop of busyness and into the leap of your true greatness. The world is awaiting your brilliance. Visit genesisofgenius.com now and step into your greatness.
Welcome back, everyone. This is Julianne Turner. We are here at Conscious Shift and really honoring all of you Conscious Shifters and are so glad that you have joined us today to talk about global values, so powerful, right? That we share common values. And when we look at what is happening across the globe and we see things that are not what we want, you know, war, famine, disagreements, you know, shootings, terrorism, all those things, then we wonder, you know, what, number one, what can we do? And number two, how can we come together to consciously co-create? And so Karin Miller's book, Global Values, gives us, you know, 10 shared values that we can start with to begin to connect through to others across the globe. And it's so encouraging that her movement is already gathering followers from all over the globe, and especially from some of the areas that we might think are actually in the most turmoil right now: the Middle East, Southeast Asia, Iraq, Egypt, Pakistan. And so that's very encouraging. And the other thing that I want to mention to you, in addition to really going within, as she suggested, and getting clear about your values, is taking some time during this season of gratitude to discover and be grateful for your unique gifts and your unique genius. To go within and really identify how you are designed to contribute to the world in a unique way through your creativity, through your unique gifts and genius. And as most of you conscious shifters know, every day I guide visionaries and thought leaders like you all across the globe to not only discover, but to profit from sharing their genius and gifts to make both the impact and the income they desire from sharing and inspiring others, from sharing their gifts and from guiding others, and from gathering their own tribe of loyal clients. So I'm doing something special Generate Gold from Your Genius sessions. This, for today, I am providing an opportunity for you listening, opening up just 3 opportunities for you to pick up one of these Genius to Gold sessions. You can go to geniussession.com and request your gift genius session right now. That's how simple it is for you to request to talk to me personally and have me guide you to clarity about your own gifts and genius, about how you can contribute those in the world to lift others up, to make an impact, to make a difference, and also to package those so that you prosper and profit from sharing those gifts and genius with your ideal tribe of loyal clients. Again, pick up a Genius to Gold session. You can do that at geniussession.com, GeniusSession.com. It's that simple. Request your session today, and I will look forward to guiding just a few of you to share the brilliance that you are meant to bring into this brave new world. Thank you so much for joining Conscious Shift today, and we will see you next time. This is Julianne Turner. Bye for now.
You've been listening to Conscious Shift with your host, Julianne Turner. If you're ready to make your own conscious shift to awaken the power and singular greatness already within you, Julianne is your expert coach and trusted ally, your passionate professional guide to create your highest purpose, profitability, and potential in your life, work, and world. Just go now to Julianne's website, www.creatorsguide.com, and fill in the special pop-up. You'll instantly receive free access to invaluable resources and bonus.